Hello, welcome to the bachelor program Soil, Water, Atmosphere. It's a bit different than normal. Normally you would be here in an audience in front of us, but now we will present it like this. What you just have been seeing is an image of the Netherlands. It's a kind of a planned view, and what you could see is that the sea level rise, what kind of impact that would have on the Netherlands. Which parts would be inundated first, which will be inundated later. And you could see that the western part of the country is inundated really quickly, and that's an area with a lot of economic activity. So what we will do, so this is the soil, water, atmosphere bachelor program. You can see here some images, and we would like to do it in kind of 35 to 40 minutes, show you what is happening and what we are doing. So let's introduce ourselves first. My name is Roel Dijksma. I'm teaching quite a bit on hydrology, so let's say water aspects at the university. And together with Judith, who is following this bachelor course, we will try to show you as good as possible what is happening here. So what you'd probably know is, what do you need to have a secondary school program to be able to register for this course? So you have to have physics, you have to have chemistry, you have to have biology and mathematics. So it is a beta study. So you have to be aware of that. It's not a really difficult beta study. So when you could do it normal, so with a normal pace, with a normal effort, you can have normal grades for this at your school. Then also when you have this normal input, you will have normal grades at the university as well. So here you can see some images of what we think this program is all about. So you can see the desertification, the floods and the drought. So the land use is changing. We are putting more pressure on the land, on the landscape. Droughts are getting more severe, like the last 2 years. The floods are getting more severe. And how can we solve these issues? Another thing is water quality. It's deteriorating quite a bit. So can we improve the water quality now and in future here and also worldwide? Another image that we have is the hurricanes and tornadoes. So these are also important. And what we do see is that tornadoes, hurricanes are causing more damage than before. Are they stronger? Are they bigger? Is there more economical activity in the area that is harmed by the tornado? What is actually happening? So what we are trying to do now is to check, for instance, here at the Gulf of Mexico, the last tornado, what is happening. And in fact, the oceans are heating up, providing more energy to the tornadoes, more water to the tornadoes, because that they are getting stronger over the years. So we have to face the fact that we're getting more severe problems with that. So climate change is a strong issue, is all over the place, and we are dealing with it now, but also we have to deal with that in future quite a bit. And food security is also an important topic that we are addressing. It is expected that in 2050 we need 2 times as much food as that we need now. So where do we get that? Do we get it on new agricultural land, or do we get it from the agricultural land that we already have? So how can we face that? So we have to intensify probably the nutrition and the water at the arable lands, as what we see here. So here also the landscape is an important factor. So you can see here an area in Belgium, here an area in Iceland. So the landscape, how did it develop? What's the morphology? What's the history of that land? And how can we use it? How can we understand it as good as possible? Another thing is ecosystem recovery. This is an image of a small brook in the eastern part of the Netherlands, and you can see a fish passage. So in the past we were just managing the water and the water levels and the discharge, and now also we want to manage the ecosystem, and we would like to combine that. So that's kind of new. Another thing, the image that you see at the lower right is models at a global scale. So what we are dealing with is point scale, really small scale experiments, really small scale understanding what's actually happening up till the total globe. What we also are dealing with is time steps of 10 minutes, for instance, for meteorology, to time steps of thousands of years or maybe even millions of years in terms of geological development. This is kind of the backbone. So what you can see here is theory. So at the upper left, you can see an image of water flow, turbulence, water is flowing over kind of a dam and is following down here and creating kind of a plunge pool and then is discharge. So what is the principle there? So what's the physics, what's the chemistry, what's the mathematics in a stream like that? But we are not only dealing with the theory and the cross sections, but we also are dealing with what is happening in the field. So here you can see two students checking on evapotranspiration from a bare arable land. And also we are trying to get these processes right. So you have to go outside. You're not only being an expert in books, in theory. But the field can be pretty difficult. So we have a lot of different processes combined, and what we can do is can go back into a kind of a lab, and it can be a physical lab, it can be a chemistry lab, and we do kind of experiments to see, to check what is actually happening there. And in the end, that boils down often to models. So here you can see an image of a model of the dunes close to Zandvoort. The yellow is sand, the brownish layers are clay layers, and these small little blue arrows are indicating what kind of flow you have. And in fact, Amsterdam is drinking from these dunes. So the drinking water supply in Amsterdam comes coming from these dunes. So what we can do is check what is happening and also check, okay, when you would like to improve or increase the water quantity and water quality for Amsterdam, what kind of impact would that have on the surrounding area? So models is also a strong component of this educational program. So it's field, theory, and modeling. When you go to the first year, it's kind of this. So we have some basic courses like mathematics, like physics, like chemistry. So all kind of courses that you kind of know from your school, names that you know from your school. Part of it is repetition, part of it is new material that you need to go to the domain courses like what we have here. And you can see environmental science, introduction to soil water atmosphere, so the name of this educational program. You have some specific courses on soil water atmosphere, and at the end of the first year there's an integration course, and that also is related to this soil water atmosphere. So quite a bit on the topic that you would do when you would follow this bachelor study. So more than half of it is already in the domain. Less than half of it, less than 50%, is linked kind of to secondary school material. And that's typical for Wageningen, that we have already so much of the topic itself in the education program in the first year, and it's also typical for this bachelor program. When you look at the second year, the basics is reduced, so still a bit of programming, still a bit of modeling, because you have to be able to do some modeling, you have to be able to create and calculate. But there is even more on domain. So here you have a couple of examples of these domain, and what you can see is system earth, geology and landscape, soil quality, hydrogeology, so all this earth science domain. So understanding the processes at these different scales. In the third year, and that's pretty important, then you specialize. The first year, we tell you which course you have to do. The second year, we tell you which course you have to do. So you don't have to worry. That's kind of the backbone, the basics of this bachelor program. In the third year, you can specialize. So when you like some component a lot, you can do more of that. And you have a lot of free choice. And these free choice you can fill in with other courses from this program, courses from related programs in Wageningen, courses from related programs in the Netherlands or even abroad. So quite a few students go abroad also to follow courses there. At the end of the third year, at kind of a roundup of this bachelor program, then you have a solo study. So on your own, you have to work on data and you have to process data, you have to elaborate on these data. And here you can see a few examples like geology, soils and landscape of Benin, summer drought in the Netherlands in 2006, rain season in Ghana. So what you can see is it's all over the place and it's all related to this kind of earth science. So you have a lot of aspects, and every year several tens of people are doing these kind of work. So this is what you are able to do, this is what you are able to research over the time. I just mentioned earth science. Here you can see the related study programs. So there will be other presentations of other bachelor programs also on the web. Here you can see Wageningen University has environmental science, intentional land and water management, landscape architecture and planning, and forest and nature conservation. And these are related to also this program. They are different. So they are kind of in the same family, like brothers or sisters, you could say. So environmental science is a bit more to sustainable development, to sustainable energy, to maybe also a little bit more to the chemistry than the soil, water, atmosphere. International land and water management is one which is really strongly linked to what we are doing, but a little bit more to the social aspects than what we do. We are a little bit more into the processes. Another one is landscape architecture and planning. So one is which is strongly linked, but also more to the social and also more to the development and to, okay, but we have all this land use. How can we deal with the all these different aspects on land use in this growing world or the growing population, you could say. And forest nature conservation is one which is strongly linked, but that is more from the ecosystems and we are more like, okay, but part of the total is ecosystem. In other universities, you can see earth system science, you can see civil engineering, future planet studies, physics, when you would like to do meteorology and applied earth science when you would go deeper into the earth. So we have a total set, but when you are looking for a bachelor program and you are also checking programs in this family, then you're, to my opinion, are on quite kind of the right track. Here you have the study numbers, something like 80 students every year. They are satisfied with what we present. Most of the students go to the second year, and when they go to the second year, they kind of finish. 76% is graduating after within 4 years. Quite a few also within 3 years. A little bit more male than female students. 60% to 40% more or less. And here you see a list of what we do. So it's always a mix of different techniques, types of education, what we do in the first year and the second year. And there's a lot of field work, a lot of practicals and excursions. And that's what you can see in this list. So to show what we are doing and to show what what students are doing in this program and how they get to the study here, we have here Judith, and Judith will explain how she did.
Thank you. Hi. So I'm Judith. I'm actually already in my master's, but that means that I finished my entire bachelor and I can tell you everything about it. Here you can see me in the salt pit during one of the excursion weekends from the study association Pyrus, that I will tell you more about in a minute. During high school, I was interested in all the beta courses like physics and chemistry, but I especially loved geography. Not the part with the humans, but everything about nature I really liked. That meant that the family of studies that Roel already talked about interested me the most. So I went to the open day of the Utrecht University and also to Wageningen. There I visited international land and water management, the forestry study, but also salt water atmosphere. And I decided that I really liked that study, so I also wanted to do some student for a day days. And after that, I decided that this was the study for me. I really liked it because it combined beta, but also the really practical side of going outside and applying the theory that you learn during the courses to what you see in the field. You can never travel through the Netherlands in the same way again. I also really like to travel abroad, and this study is not rare to go abroad to study for a while or even to work there. What I really liked about it when I was studying was that it was a small group. I knew everyone from a year, and I also know all the teachers by first name. When I run into them in the shops in Wageningen, there's a good possibility that you will stop for small talk. I also really like that you have a broad basis. You have a basis in soil, water, and atmosphere. In my master's, I decided to focus on atmosphere, but a lot of my friends from the first year are now specialized in the soil. So you can still go in every direction you would like. Most important to me, the small groups, the good supervision, and the friendly atmosphere. I will show you some courses and some excursions because, to be honest, that's the most fun part. This is a course from the first year. It's still in Wageningen, but with a small group, you get an area. And for that area, you have to do some basic analysis to see what's possible there for the future. We, for example, decided to build an amusement park. So I did wind measurements to see if I could build a roller coaster there. This is a practical from the second year. There's Roel. And you go to the Achterhoek. There you again do some measurements of the environment, but at a higher level now. And there is also a course to which you travel to the entirety of the Netherlands. So you go to all the provinces, have a look at the landscape, and you learn how it is formed in that way. In the third year, you go abroad for the first time. First, not that far, you start in Belgium. This is the course Hydrogeology. And there you learn how the landscape is formed. That means that first you travel around the area, and Roel tells you everything about it. But on the third and fourth day of the excursion, they just dump you in an area, and you have to make a map of that and explain where the water is coming from to your peers at the end. There are more field trips in the third year. There's one for the metrology. You go to different institutes in Germany, for example, the German equivalent of the KNMI. And you learn how they do their research and how to do a weather forecast, that kind of stuff. But there is also a geology course, which travels to Germany and France for 2 weeks. And then you have, for example, a lecture on a volcano. That's one of the coolest things I've ever done during my studies. But next to the studies, there's also the study association, PIRES. A study association is something different than a student association because it's only with people from your study. This means that there are study-related activities, but there's also a lot of fun activities. Well, the study-related ones are fun as well, but you get what I mean. You have drinks, a prom, an introduction weekend, excursions, again, and the soldering championship. I will tell you more about that in a minute. These are some pictures. This is a picture from the prom, and these are some from the weekends we went away with the study association, and it's mainly a lot of games, just very relaxing weekend with lots of fun. And these are other excursions, like this one to Austria. And this one is, this is a picture taken in Slovenia. Then the soul drilling championships. That's one event we organize every year, and it draws over 800 students from the entirety of the Netherlands. And the goal is to drill a hole in the crowd as quickly as possible. Well, you can just participate in this event, but you can also organize it, like I did. That means that with a committee, you come together for half a year, and you just put in a lot of effort to make it as big a party as possible. And I would definitely recommend you to do committees as well, because you make friends for life during that. And you also learn a lot, but it's mostly so much fun. There's more you can do in Wageningen, except from everything related to the study. I, for example, also did a board year with the Dancing Association, but you can check out videos where they tell you more about student life in Wageningen and how to find a room.
Yeah. Continue a bit on excursion. You did just mentioned excursion. So let's say I give excursions, so in the Netherlands and abroad, but the study association, PIRES, is creating its own excursion. So that's on top of the regular excursion. So that's, I think, a very nice thing During the summer holiday, they go abroad and have an excursion with a lot of soil, water, atmosphere related topics. And the drilling championship is kind of a strange thing, you could say. Maybe you could call it the Dutch championship, because it's the only one, if I'm correct. And indeed, 800 people are showing up working in clay. It's not on the list of the prerequisites, but you do have to do that. You are able to drill really fast into clay soils. But it's a lot of people from Wageningen, a lot of people from other universities, also from Amsterdam, from Delft, Utrecht. Sometimes the dentists also like to come because they also drill. So it's a big happening. It's kind of a, well, you could almost say kind of a carnival here in Wageningen. Then, after finishing the bachelor, so I hope that we have given a bit of an idea of what you can do during the bachelor. But what then? So what can you do then? So the bachelor is 3 years, like most of the bachelors in the Netherlands. And here you have the option that what you can do after finishing the bachelor. So Earth and Environment is a master program at Wageningen University, and you can follow that. And that's the logical follow-up of this bachelor. So again, Earth science related. So the somewhat deeper underground up till the higher layers in the atmosphere. When you say, okay, but climate is something that is really puzzling me and is interesting me, and I would like to do more with that, then climate studies is also a master program that you can easily step into. And it's also climate modeling, but also looking at, okay, but what are the social impacts of climate? So it's a very broad in master program in relation to climate. Geoinformation science, we get more and more data now from satellites, from all kind of automatic equipment, also hand measurements. How can we use that in the best possible way to predict, to describe what is actually happening? The geoinformation science can be a good one. Development of rural innovation can be a nice one. That's more into the social part and also related to, let's say, the third world country. So what, when you have the techniques, when you have the knowledge, how can you bring that to the people, if you like? You can also do another master program in Wageningen, but then you have to be aware of the difference between this bachelor and the master program that you would like to do, so that you can have a pre-master program as intermediate. You can also do it at other universities in the Netherlands and abroad, and you can even create your own master program if you like, but that's not the easiest road. Then you have to have also permission from the examiner committee, but it is possible. You can work with a bachelor degree, but not many do it, because it's a good idea to continue with this two-year master program. So these are all 2 years, to see to get more chances on the labor market, and it really helps. So you can go working with the bachelor degree, but you would not do it. So Master Earth and Environment is the most relevant one. Here you can see some pictures of a student in Iceland. So there's also excursions, modeling, thesis work. And also we'd like to show the world how it works at a better degree. So here we have the first job. So when you finish your bachelor and you finish your master, what can you do then? So here you can see a word cloud about what has been done in the recent past. And you can see PhD, which means that you will start a program at one university, Wageningen, Netherlands, abroad, and then you can become a doctor in the end. So doctor in philosophy, it's officially called, but then you even are improving your possibilities even more. So really a research. You can be a consultant, you can be a specialist, you can be a junior researcher. So there's a lot to do. So you have a lot of job opportunities after graduation. This list, this word cloud, is just some words. Here we have a few examples of people graduated on this bachelor and master program in the recent past. Jasper Kandel is the first example. He did his master thesis in Moscow, Idaho. There we have really a strong drawdown of the groundwater table because of high abstraction rates. How can you bring more water into the ground layers there now to replenish this water level. After that, he went to Canada, a little bit north of this Idaho, Moscow, and looked at inundations of Calgary. There's a large river there, the Bow and the Elbow River, and they are inundating the land, and he made a map of the city where the inundation risk was and how to mitigate these problems and how to understand what these rivers are doing. And he recently graduated on his PhD research on the Vecht near Dalsen, and what you can see here nicely is that what we are doing nowadays is creating the brooks, the small brooks in the eastern part of the country, as such that they are nicely meandering again. And he's looking at the subsoil, how can you do that in a natural way, so like building with nature, you could say. Susanne Poik is another one. Here, you do not only see her first job, but a series of jobs. So she graduated some years ago. She started as a vice hydrology at Royal Haskoning, a large engineering agency. Saw an advert for hydrological modeler in New Zealand, advisor water at Grondmei. Later on, she went advisor and project leader at Goedwijs, and now she is at Staatsbosbeheer, National Forestry Service, and is team lead. So you can see her jobs developed from researcher, from modeler to team leader. So that's typical what we see in our brand. And what you can also see is that the world is your playground. So she could do it in the Netherlands, she is doing it in the Netherlands, but she also can do it in New Zealand even. And for the parents, they come back. You can see she went to New Zealand for a couple of years and then she saw a new advert and became pregnant even. I don't know whether that was one extra hint to come back, but then she went to Grondmei in the end. So when you like this topic, and you know the theory, you know the process, and you can do it all over the place, all over the world. Here you can see Dirk Malda, major group, so meteorological data, and what you can see is that for aviation, for the planes, the pilots need information about the weather conditions. For navigation, the captains of boats need information, but it's different what they need. For the weather forecast, what we use at the National News is different. So what Dirk is doing is trying to work on this huge set of data and make it really ready for consumption for the people with some ideas about what they would like to do with the weather. Is it a relevant study? So I think you can see that at least we think it's interesting, that we like it, that we enjoy doing it, but is it just fun to know it, or is it relevant for the world, for the population? So we think it is true, and here you can see some recent images, the heat islands. So this global warming is happening, the cities, the urbanization is happening. And what does that do? And here you can see a colleague working in the big cities, in Amsterdam or Rotterdam, and trying to check on how warm these islands are. And here you have Rotterdam and Delft and The Hague. You can see how much warmer it is there compared to the surrounding area, the rural area. North Pole research is actually going on. There's a boat is stuck in the ice, and that's on purpose. And there's a lot of measurements on the North Pole happening now to see, okay, but what is this global warming doing, and how is it infecting, having impact on the poles? Here, the relevance of the water resources. We need more water. We are with more people. We need more food. And here you can see a map. And in fact, the dark blue is where there's a lot of water available in easy ground layers. And brown is difficult. And the lighter the color is, less water is going into the system. So where you can see the dark brown and dark blue, there we have plenty of water, for instance in the Amazon, but we cannot use it. And at other locations, we have very little water, and we need the water there. So worldwide, water is getting a larger problem, so you can also see that here in the population distribution. Drought, I think you know, last year was really warm. The year before that was really warm. So we get more and more problems with drought and not enough water for vegetation and also for drinking water supply. So 1976 is also an image that was a very dry year, but now we had two in a row, and maybe it will be even three in a row. So when you recognize yourself in this, more or less, when you think, okay, but I'm curious about how the world as a system is operating, how these processes are working. When you have the broad interest, and when you are adventurous, more or less, so not afraid to go abroad, when you have affinity with mathematics, with physics, chemistry, and biology, then we kind of offer this. So it's a multidisciplinary program. You have a strong link with staff and students. It's not too large a bachelor program, like something like 80 students per year. And the job perspective and good salary is, of course, related to economy, but also in periods with not so good economy, then still the graduates will get a job pretty easily in the area of interest. So we cannot look 5 years ahead, but we expect that to will be good as well. Here we have some extra info. I'm not talking in English. The master program or the bachelor program is in English, and we do not expect that to be a problem. Nobody left the program because of the language up till now. Most of them graduated with it in this 4 years, as indicated. We have the study choice check, additional costs. So we are talking about a lot of excursions and field practicals and study materials. It is an order of magnitude of extra costs in the order of 30, 40 euros per month, maybe, for the books, for the readers, and what you have to pay for excursions or practicals, if you like. And what we have here is for the 14th time in a row, as university, we were ranked as best university, and also the program is ranked to the best program. So that's always nice, but you have to be careful about these values, because the students of this program are ranking their program and their university, and others are doing it for their program and their university. You can't say we are better or worse, but at least you can see they like it being here. Here we have some general aspects. So the honors program is so when you would like to have more info, even when you think at your school, okay, but I can absorb more, I can do more, you can do that. We have some program for that. We have a study advice, and you have to meet at least 36 of the 60 possible credits in the first year. If not, you need to have a good reason why you did not do that. What you can do from now today is to chat with the study advisor. They are available. You can chat with the student to see and get answer to your the questions that you have. So you should not end up with questions, it's a bit different, but still you can get all the information that you would like to have now to make a good choice for your study. So we have to frequently ask questions also, so try to get all the information that you have. We are there for you. So with that, good luck with your study choice, maybe with your exam when you're in the sixth year, and let's hope that we meet. Okay, goodbye.